the Tomb Raider reboot incorporated technology that allowed for some stunning graphics. But we don't give a fuck about that. This is the LowSpec Gamer, where we laugh in the face of minimum system requirements and tweak everything in the game that makes it beautiful until we get it to run in our crappy computers. And we show you how to do it. So forget about fancy dress effects, hairs, and any sort of quality texture, because we're going to make this game run.
And I knew what I must become.
Okay, we're going to start with the game running on 1080p, vertical sync on double buffer, and a normal preset for quality. We all know this is not going to work, but it is a good reference to compare against. If you run the game's so-called benchmark, which is entirely composed of Lara standing there breathing heavily, I'm not even joking here, this is all there is, we get something around 20 frames per second. In practice, once you hit the game, you get a maximum of 20 and mostly around 15 during action. So, time to reduce the settings. The good news is that, unlike games like Darksiders, this is actually a quality port with plenty of options. We're going to reduce the resolution to 720, turn off vertical sync, and use the game's low quality preset. As you can see, this turns off most of the effects and reduces the quality of the textures and details into low. Excellent! The game now looks like something out of a first generation PlayStation 2 game. We are going for real Tomb Raider authenticity here. The benchmark now shows us a performance of almost 60 frames per second. And how does that translate to the actual game? Poorly, actually. Many sections of the game are now much better, with frame rates of around 40 frames per second or more. However, you will eventually run into intense sections where the frame rate drops way under what is playable for an alarming period of time. And that gives me an opportunity to show you our first tweak. In order to tweak the game any further, we need access to the game's registry. To get there, go into your Windows search and type regedit, which is the Windows Registry Edition tool. Now that we are in the tool, we need to find the Tomb Raider registry. This is located at hkey current user, software, Crystal Dynamics, which is the name of the company that developed this game, Tomb Raider graphics, and here we are. Now, our first tweak is very simple. If you have seen my Arkham Origins video, you will know that if you're using an old video card, you can probably get a better performance on a game by using an old version of DirectX. The parameter that controls the DirectX version is called Render API, and you can force it to use DirectX 9 by clicking it and changing the value to 9. Well, that looks better. Start digging into the game, and the increase is not as dramatic, but very much noticeable. Not only on the inside, but even when running around in some of the big areas in the game. Combat, where multiple enemies are involved, will make it a little bit slower, as we will come to expect, but most of the time it will stay among the 25-30 range, which we can work with. Also, how come I am being attacked by enemies with bows and knives while I am using a machine gun? This doesn't feel very fair. There are areas later in the game where we encounter more difficulties, such as the road to the shantytown over here. Worry not, because there is still a little tweak that we can do to improve this. Back to our registry edit tool. First, for some reason, the low quality texture is not the lowest you can go. If you want, you can edit the texture quality registry to 1. It will not make a lot of visual difference, and in my experience, you can get a couple of frames out of slow areas. Now, there is one value we can add here that, according to the internet, will make a difference on places like Shantytown by allowing the game to better utilize multiple cores on the CPU. The value is called multi-core flush mode. You probably do not have this value on your Tomb Raider registry, so you can add it by right-clicking on empty space, selecting new, and the new DWORD 32-bit value. Name your new value to multi-core flush mode. I am going to delete this one because I already have it. Edit the value so it is equal to 1. I decided to test some of the most intense areas I have encountered with this configuration. While there are still unavoidable drops in performance in areas with many particle effects, wind, or moving elements, the game is able to maintain itself over 20 frames per second and usually around 30. I also want to see how the game fared on some of the most intense action scenes, since there is usually so much stuff flying around and the game has a hard time, but so far the game has been able to keep up. This area was particularly interested in since games on my laptop usually struggle when water is involved, but I saw no particular difference in the performance of holy sh**. That is disturbing! When did this game become Mortal Kombat? While on previous games, all my tweaks have improved the frame rate on every laptop I have tried them on, Tomb Raider is a little bit unpredictable. For example, I tried running the game on a system with an integrated Intel HD card and turning DirectX to 9 gave very good results, but when I tried my older NVIDIA card with DirectX 9 and multi-core flush mode enabled at the same time, the performance was actually worse. If I change render API to 1 and leave multi-core flush mode on, the performance actually increased so much I was able to change the quality preset to normal. Look at me playing now, no muddy graphics! My recommendation is that you pick an area of the game where you get a stable frame rate, and you mix and experiment with render API and multi-core flush mode until you get the best performance for your system. This is all for this episode. If these videos are being helpful to you, don't forget to subscribe and like so I can keep making them. Also, do you have a recommendation on which game should I try to get to work next? Feel free to let me know through comments, Twitter, or any media you desire. Until next time. Is it just me, or does this game have a lot of quick time on rail events such as this one? I am not really the biggest fan of- Ah, shit! Impaled again.